All right. Opening a new scene. Okay. So let's go to Windows, Settings, and Preferences, and Plugin Manager. Bring up the Plugin Manager. And here, just search for mocopi. Then, you can just load it by selecting the loaded checkbox. An auto-load will make it, so it loads every time you launch Maya. So I'll leave it as that. I'll close it, and you can see that the mocopi shelf was created. There's a button here. Go ahead and press it. That will create a new, more copy window. And for reference, you can create more of these windows if you have multiple mocopi sets and actors. But for this video, I'll just cover one data stream. And for reference, you can just change the port. And that's how you would have multiple data streams. And also, you can recall these windows by selecting these buttons over here. So, with the window open, let's hit the Create Character button. It creates a skeleton. Then, make sure you have your local IP of this PC. So put this IP on your mocopi app on the phone. And make sure you have the same port here as well. With that said, hit Live, and then it says here, awaiting skeleton definition. So now you can start your stream on the app. And so once you start your stream, you'll see here, it says data received. So we can press this bind to character button. And you can see now that I am doing the live motion in Maya. If you recalibrate, or if you have different actor wearing the sensors, you might need to press the bind to character again when you start another stream. But the plugin window will tell you, hey, you need to press this button again. So now with the live data in, let's try to create a recording. So before that, make sure that you have cache playback disabled. Right, so make sure that's disabled. And then on the settings here, the playback time slider settings, make sure your playback speed is whatever your frame rate is times 1. So change it from play every frame. All right. So to create a recording, we need to enable the recording checkbox here. So enabling that, it will tell you, use the play and stop button to create a recording. So the playing stop button are located here. So hit play. And now you are recording. Make sure you, do your motion, do whatever you need to do. And then once you're ready, hit stop to stop the recording. And now to actually save and create those animation curves, you need to uncheck this box. So once I uncheck this, you'll see that it'll create the animation curves over here. But I'm still previewing the live motion. So if I want to review what I recorded, I need to uncheck the live. You can see here it's playing back. And you can see how all the keyframes were recorded there. And I can hit play to review my recording. So that's really all you need to do to get the live motion data of mocopi into Maya and start creating recordings with your character. So now let's try applying this motion onto a character. So I'm going to import one of my characters. Here you go. Okay. And so basically we're just using the HIK mechanism in Maya to retarget the motion. So go to the HIK menu here on the right. And if you don't see this, it's this icon over here on the top right. It brings up that menu. And what you need to do is just select your character. So in my case, it would be my target character. It is going to be Eric. And then my source is going to be my mocopi character. So now you can see that the mocopi skeleton is basically animating the mesh that I imported. And finally, if I wanted to bake that animation onto the mesh, I would select my target mesh, and then I would make sure I'm in the animation mode here on the top left, and then select Edit, Keys, Bake Simulation, and make sure the below option is selected and hit Apply. It's going to run through the animation. And there it is, close. So now if I delete my mocopi stuff, you'll see that the mesh is animating. And now I have that animation that I just recorded baked onto my character. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And then, just one more time, if you had two, if you had another actor with another mocopi set, you would do the same procedure. You would just make sure that the port is different, here in the plugin, as well as in its respective application. And that's all. Thank you.